projects. Maybe to talk about solar in general for the continent of Africa and especially for our country of Uganda. As Africans, we are known as the dark continent. Why are we known as the dark continent? Not only because of our color of our skin, but most especially because 2 out of 3 Africans still do not have access to power or to renewable energy. If the continent is of 1.1 billion Africans, then it means more than 800 Africans do not have access to power. Why is that the case? Power is one of the most, one of the fundamentals of development. We say Africa is a backward continent. How do we make Africa develop? For every 1% increase in your gross domestic product, you need a 2% increase on your energy. So for us as Africans to develop and to become the future, we need an increase in our power generation. Some of us have been lucky to be able to extract oil, say like our brothers on the West African side, they are using oil for their power. Us in the Great Lakes region of Eastern Central Africa, our primary source is renewable energy because of all the lakes and the water we have. But as you have seen, that is not enough. Currently, we are doing around 300,000 connections per year. And if, as Ugandans say, we are 40 million and more than 85% of us do not have access to power, it means we have millions of our citizens who do not have access to grid power. And it will take us 100 years and more to reach 100% universal electricity. So what is the solution for us? Despite being known as the dark continent, we are also known as the light continent. Why is that? Africa, more than any other place in the world, receives longest hours of uninterrupted sunshine during the day. Some parts of the world only get partial sunshine. However, as Africa, we have it all through the full year. However, the greatest resource which we have, which is on top of our head, we do not fully use it to our benefit. Why is that? One, we are not aware of the technology. Ignorance of the technology which is there to help us. If many of us knew about solar energy, how it works, how it is, powers, how we can be able to transform lives, then many more of us would be able to adopt it and use it for our households. So that is one of the reasons why we all need to understand how solar energy works, or how renewable energy in general works, but specifically solar for this matter, but not only how to use it, but also how to design appliances, how to design systems, how to repair them, and that is how we can be able to create the adoption to go much, much more higher in our societies. But in addition, here we see how solar power can be used for agriculture, which is one of our key economic drivers, say in Uganda, but also in Greater Africa. What am I talking about? Here we see solar water pumping solutions. For example, this is a surface water pump, which is powered by 3 water panels and is able to pick water from a horizontal surface. So if you have a stream, say if you have a river, say if you have a pond somewhere near your farm, through a pump like this, you're able to pull water from that pond and be able to irrigate your garden. One of the key challenges we face in Africa is water supply for our agriculture. We find that our crops dry out, we only do seasonal agriculture, but through solutions such as solar water pumping, we're able to do full year all-round agriculture. Anything can wait except food on the table. Africa, this is a time for us to adopt solar water pumping solutions to enable us to create food security, transform our communities, and build the development which we require. I will ask my colleagues to just turn it on for us so that we can be able to see it. Shortly, it will come on. Then also, in addition to surface water pumps, we also have a different type of pump here, which I'll be able to pull and show you. Here we have a bigger version of a steel of that particular pump. It is also still a solar water pump, but now this is for bigger farming. So you have 5 acres and above. These are the kind of solutions which you have. They can be able to do almost 1,000 meters on surface and 500 meters below surface, and are able to create food security through ensuring that water supply is continuous. However, we also have water usage situations whereby you find that the water is underground. You need to dig a well and you need to put a submersible pump. These are typically powered AC-powered solutions, so you find that they are not accessible, say, to rural households or to people working in deep villages. However, solar now, we also have a submersible solar water pump, which is this one just right here. It goes right deep into a well and pulls water up to the top and can be able to be used for the same purpose. So in addition to the surface water pumps, we also have submersible water pumps, which can also still be able to be used to create the same impact. This is a 50-watt module. For the module is what gets power from the sun and transports it 2, a battery for storage, and further for usage. Before the module, each module, say a 50-watt module, has an accompanying battery size, which is what you see behind here. So here we have a 45 Ah, or rather around 50 Ah battery, which moves with that panel. So when the panel gets power from the sun, it is always deposited into the battery, and for the battery, you can be able to extract to use for lighting. However, in between, we have what we call a solar charge controller. If you can just follow me to the left, here you can see a fully installed system. This is a solar charge controller, which is connected to the two modules you can see outside there. So from the modules, the power comes into the charge controller, which then regulates it. It takes some and puts directly into the batteries for storage, for even in use when there is no power. However, if you have loads already connected, it can also take the power directly to your lighting bulbs. As you can see an example here, we have a set of 3-watt lights and 9-watt lights, which are sufficient, say one for a small room, or maybe for a bigger room, or even for security purposes. In addition to providing the panels and the battery and the power and the lights which go with the solar system, we also do a number of solar appliances. Say for example, you can see at the very top, we have a security light which can also be used for solar to be able to power your lights or boosters. In addition to that, we also have appliances, say like solar fridges. And you can see this is a DC chest freezer. It is already on. You can even feel the cold. It's already ice inside it. Also, when you're thinking about solar, you find that access to finance is also one of the key challenges which is preventing us as Africans to adopt the technology. Solar systems are still quite expensive, and this is partly because we're not taking advantage of the economies of scale. If more of us were to use solar systems, understand and start adopting them, the prices would generally go lower for all of us, we'll be able to afford much more, and we'd be able to develop our countries. If indeed energy is the key to development, then for Africa, there is no other option. We need to use the resources which we have, one of them which is the sun, to not only develop our societies, develop our communities. How we do that is first by understanding what the technology is, how it works, and how it can benefit us. And thus, that is why all of us need to join hands together to build renewable energy solutions for Africa for a better and a greener future, not only for us, but especially for the generations to come. Africans, this is our time. Let's use the resources we have to build our future. We are used to getting loans, we are used to begging, yet the sun is shining bright on top of our heads every day. Let's use it to generate income for ourselves, for our families, and transform our societies.